And we're back with some more oxygen not included. And we have, well, a lot of things all about to happen at once. What we've got down here is we're installing some wheezewort. Now, the reason for that is we want this wheezewort down here because it's going to pump out a whole bunch of rads into the surrounding area. I mean, don't get me wrong, this place is already heavily irradiated, but it could be more irradiated. Now, Jerome should come back immediately to supply that with frostrite. And when he does, he should go to harvest the gas grass. This gas grass is fully ripened, but we want to expose it to the maximum amount of rads before we actually, before we harvest it, just to crank up the odds of us getting a mutation as high as possible so that we can knock out a mutation achievement. Now, when it comes over to this planet here, we have managed to collect up all the resources nearby. Our people should be just finishing their naps, are they? No, Brendan's sleeping late. There we go. A couple of storage bins, well, three storage bins and a pedestal. That should allow us to take all of the necessary items off of here. Namely, we're taking all the iron ore with us. We can always use more steel back home. We're also going to take all the dash of salt vine seeds. And the very last thing we're going to load up is the nosh sprouts because, well, we need those back home to get a mutation achievement again. Oh, and we're going to take that stethoscope. And please tell me that seed analysis is something good. No, that is a sleep week mutation. And oh, please tell me. Come on. What did you get? Oh, but I don't think we even got a seed. Pity. We used our best farmer as well. All right, and down here, we're about to expand our hydrogen production. Yeah, I'll explain that in a minute. While this is going on, we've just about loaded up this this shuttle. I think we've got everything off the planet already in. Let's deconstruct all of that, deconstruct that, and get ourselves out of here. Oh, yeah, that should probably go as well. That perfect. We have stripped this planet of everything we have wanted. Now it's time to just head back home. Oh, wait, we'll have to delete that tile, won't we? Yep, catches me every time. Good work, dupes. You did an excellent job, and you've managed to leave some steel behind, but that's fine, and some meat. No bothers whatsoever. You'll be back home in no time. And then we can use your construction skills back home to finish the next step of our plan. Oh, it's getting warm in here. Don't let it get too warm. The body temperature of our beta hive is starting to heat up in here, and that is bad. But a quick ice temperature shift plate should cool things down here a bit. We want to keep this place very cold, for reasons that'll become very obvious very soon. So, the reason behind this weird-looking construction project is actually to do with hydrogen production. We're going to use Saturn critter traps. They consume water and critters, and they produce hydrogen and plant meat. Yeah, that'll give us a whole bunch more hydrogen to start filling this up a lot more rapidly. Otherwise, we're looking at a little bit of a downside in hydrogen production at the moment. I was going to just make a whole bunch of, make a giant electrolyzer, like a second one of these, but someone in the comments was like, hey, why not give these a go? And I figure, why not, actually? They look pretty handy if we can get them to work. The thing is, they need polluted water, and they need to be kept below 0 degrees. So we need cold polluted water, which we have a fair amount of. Namely because that's all of the cold polluted water over here. This polluted water used to be over here somewhere, and then it used to be over here somewhere before that. We fed it from this cool slush geyser, and we were going to use it to make steel. But then we ended up not using it for some reason. I think, oh yeah, our industrial sauna came online. Now, you know what? We'll just take the gold amalgam. There's no need to be fancy right there. Down here, we should be just getting in the first batches of water. It's -2. Perfect. Anything, so long as it's just slightly into the minuses, is fine. Ooh. Come on, all the way to the end. Ever gonna get there? What happened to that? Did that thing... Oh, it overheated. Yeah, oops. Now, last I checked, Saturn critter traps did not eat betas, as in those bee tinies. But I've been advised that it has since changed, so we'll find out in a minute. If they do eat bee tinies, this is going to be really handy because we'll have an effectively infinite source of food right there. If they don't eat bee tinies, well, then we're probably in a lot more trouble. But there I was, carefully watching this beta hive, when one of our ships came back home and I was like, what the hell happened here? Why are you all in here? Then I realized, atmosphere checkpoint. Yeah, oops. Now we got to get everyone back into a suit again. Oh, this is going to kill me. How many lead suits did we drop off here? Anyway, ignoring all of the people who lost the rad suits and all of that stupidity, down here we're sucking the atmosphere out of this room. This is all going to become hydrogen after a while, and this thing actually has 20 kilos of hydrogen in it, but it's at 4.3 degrees, and I don't know why. The plant is definitely not at 4.3 degrees. It's at minus 4.2. The tile it's on is at minus 5. The air behind it is at minus 8. This thing should not be generating hydrogen at that temperature. Also, I haven't... Well, it does appear to be able to be tinies, which is good for us. In fact, what if we were to, say, get a little bit of a... Where is it? Food. Under food, we can grab a critter drop-off. We could just migrate a whole bunch of bee tinies into this room and just load them all up right now. Oh, wait, wait. I see your next meal. Come on, buddy. Come on. There you go. That's actually pretty handy. Now, the weird thing about these things is they produce hydrogen, but they don't... There's no actual rhyme or reason behind it. If you fertilize them or do anything like that, they still produce the exact same amount of hydrogen per cycle. You can get... I don't think you can get mutated versions of these, and at the same time, if you just have them growing wild, they still produce the exact same amount of hydrogen, meaning they'll grow much slower, require no resources, you just have to put a bee tiny hive near them, a beta hive near them, and you can grow lots and lots of hydrogen for effectively free. Downside is you would need to get the pips to plant them, and the pips would probably freeze at those temperatures. Actually, we should have some pips around here somewhere to actually check what their freeze temperature is. Never mind, pips can survive down to minus 30, meaning, yeah, no problems there. So, yeah, that's actually a handy way of making lots of hydrogen. Basically, wild plant the Saturn traps and stick some beta hives beside them, and they'll just generate you a whole butt ton of hydrogen, assuming this thing ever pops. I think it has to hit 30 kgs before it starts popping, and what are we at for oxygen in the room? Yeah, if it pops now, we should be fine. Well, this proved to be slightly more complicated than I was anticipating. I decided to run the water down here in the background to try and, you know, soak up the heat from the hydrogen. The problem with that was the pipes when I first built them were about 20 degrees, and then that of course sucked a whole bunch of temperature out of the room or chill out of the room, and then we ended up getting too warm, and then the plants were stifling. So I've thrown in a couple of wheezewarts to help chill the place down, and I've also thrown in a bunch of temperature shift plates made out of ice, which should slowly, they shouldn't actually melt in here, but they should help dump in a whole bunch of chill without hopefully freezing the water in the pipes, which is one thing I'm kind of worried about. But No, it's starting to stabilize just about. Almost there. Now that this is, well, about the right temperature, we're going to add in a few more sacrifices. Should be no problems. We'll dump them in there. They'll fill that up. Now, while we're going in here, we might as well harvest the uranium. I haven't been bothering to harvest it. What are we at? 3 tons. 3 tons. 3 tons. Okay, so 18 tons of enriched uranium. Well, that seems like... It seems like a good day. Now hold on while we harvest all of this. Right now we have 762 kilos of enriched uranium. And, oh, and we've also got another 1700 kilos of enriched uranium over there. But soon enough we should have lots and lots of this stuff. And, hey! Welcome to this new location. Now, come on. Come on. You know you want to go and have a little bit of a wander. All of you do. There's so much free space. Look, there's one of your friends over there. Why don't you two meet in the middle and try and play? Alright. And come on, come on. Yoink. And that's more hydrogen. Enriched uranium, we're up to 14 tons. That's great. Once they've finished harvesting the last of these, I'll seal this off again. Oh, damn it. Some of them are turning into bees. Just, no. Damn it. All right, well, we wait to see if any more of them join us in our trap. This hydrogen is getting pumped out over here, and oh, and it's going to get joined up with that. Oh, damn it. Don't you hate it when that happens? Yeah, we'll put in a bridge there. And that will bring it all the way up to the top of the map. Well, that was a horrifying mess, but now, nope, back to normal. Come on, there you go. There you go. Damn, that is a solid line of hydrogen. I hope I didn't send too much. That'll probably be fine. Yeah, soon that'll be getting up there, and that will really ramp up hydrogen production for us. Okay, but down here, we're just going to grab a few more of these bee tinies, feed them into our little system here, and that should give us far more hydrogen to work with. Like, those things are actually churning out quite a bit. This should, if we once we rip out the wheezewarts and put in two more there, this should churn us out about half a kilo of hydrogen per second. This is working out incredibly well. We've let it run for a bit, and it produces a lot of hydrogen. Not quite half a kilo per second. We haven't got we're a tiny bit shy, but it's damn close. That is really boosting hydrogen production. It is far better than actually putting in a whole electrolyzer system. Far, well, easier as well. In fact, hydrogen-wise, we've already started rotating in that tank, and we've got about 1.3 tons in storage with food poisoning germs. How is there food poisoning germs? You're chilled down to minus 250. You're like, those must be the toughest germs ever. Oh, okay, right. Who cares? Now, what we're going to do? Ah, yes, we're going to launch off two of these rockets. Well, we're going to launch off two of these rockets once I'm finished demolishing all of that insulated gas piping there. We want the igneous rock back because we're running out of, well, everything. These two rockets we're going to launch back out to get us some supplies. This one is just your standard one. If we go to change here, we're going to fire this off over there. And we're going to immediately launch that one. This one over here, slightly different. This one here, we're going to send over to the helium cloud. In fact, we'll begin the launch sequence there as well. The reason for the helium cloud is this thing has got a gas canister on it and a liquid cargo canister. They're a little bit smaller than full size, but that's okay. Reason being, if you check over here, this cloud has hydrogen, 20% hydrogen, 80% water, which means we should get 2 tons of hydrogen out of this thing. Which, yes, I want 2 tons of hydrogen. That would really go a long way towards fueling up our rockets very, very quickly and efficiently. All right, well, those two are away. It's time to fuel these rockets up again and get them on their way. Also, we have two more planets in range that we need to explore. The two planets to explore in range are this one over here, which is the asteroid planet, or the regolith planet, but has shovels. We need to get shovels and build a bunker door there. And the other one is over here. I'm actually sure what's on there that we need, but we'll have a quick look. And then that one's too far away, and that one is too far away, so we're going to have to wait for hydrogen rockets for those. Give me a minute while I get the crews together. These should be our last colonization missions involving, well, radiation engines for quite a while, hopefully. Yeah, they'll be on their way shortly. Our other two rockets are in transit. Wow, they're taking a long time. You're 1.5 cycles. Zap really is the faster flyer on this. Alright, now, while that is going on, since our entire good build team is away, we're kind of stuck in what we can do. There's not really many good projects. For example, if you wanted to say, oh, I don't know, dig out this. Yep, we don't have anyone who's actually capable of digging obsidian right now. Our best diggers and builders are away having fun. So what I'm going to do here is we're going to queue up some salt to table salt. And honestly, we don't care about the table salt. It's not the table salt that matters. It's we're going to grind down salt and get 100 kilos of sand out of it. So we're able to convert our salt to sand, which is good because we've only got 21 tons of salt left. Or 21 tons of sand left. Salt-wise, we've got 207 tons. So we technically have 207 tons of sand. We've just got to get some duplicants to smash it up first. It could take some time, but, you know, we can wait. In the meantime, we're going to have to wait for, was it this rocket to get back? It's going to bring back an absolutely ludicrous amount of hydrogen. It's already up to almost a full ton. That's a lot. Oh, well, we'll worry about that later. Checking down here on our gas grass, it's been horrifyingly bad. We've got 4 seeds from it so far, and not a single one has been a mutant. Not a single mutant seed. Hey, Grub, want to get out of the way? You're kind of blocking everyone's view. And the rads on its spot are 3,000. It's got 3,000 rads right there. That is insane. Yep, 3,000 rads right on top of it, and it still won't give us a mutation. Okay, you better give us one soon, otherwise we're going to have to go and get more chlorine. Down here we managed to find a whole bunch of chlorine. We actually got a few kilos of this stuff when we were mopping up down here. Turns out there was actually quite a few kilos of carbon dioxide down here as well that had liquefied. We're going to have to do something about that, but that's for later. For now, we just need 1 seed to drop mutated and we can move on to our next one, which is the Noshbrats. Actually, I should probably get around to making some ethanol for those. Yeah, they require ethanol to be irrigated, and we do have some wood around here somewhere. You know, I'm not bothered making the ethanol just yet. I'm going to wait till the team are home. Instead, I'm going to start this loop. We want to loop out the hydrogen. And, oof, yeah, that's to there. Oh, running out rapidly. Almost. There we go. So I think we made it the whole way to the end. We're going to need a little bit more ceramic, and we took all the clay from our secondary planet and brought it all back here. So we actually have 12 tons of clay we're turning into ceramic. That all came from Contrilia over here, which reminds me. Halo, time to go. There's only one person on this planet right now, and now there will be 0 people. There was no point in keeping this place. We did basically strip mine everything we had needed. Now we just have to reskill Halo and hope he integrates into the new team. Did you ever have that annoying problem where you're trying to get one of those pipes in the middle of a tank and it just, you can't get down to build it? No problems. All you have to do is move down your ladder. In this case, it's your Spacefarer module. It seems it's real simple to just chuck it down a level. And then there you go. Everyone's right on top of it. They can stand here and just build it. Or you can, well, up or down, wherever the hell you want it. We'll have to replace it once we want to get the liquids flowing again. But this makes things an awful lot simpler when it comes to constructing these pipes. Now it's time to get this precious, precious, precious hydrogen flowing. Oh, and I think our rockets have just arrived. For that, we're going to get ceramic. We should have at least two pieces. Yep. And we're going to hook that up there. Actually, we can... Damn it. We'll hit cancel and get rid of that overwrite. There's actually igneous rock tiles there, so we don't want to waste a piece of ceramic doing that. So joined and joined. Then what we'll do is we'll deconstruct this liquid bridge and we're going to make that an incredibly high priority. See, what's happening here is there's actually a little bit of a flow control there, so we're losing a kilo out this direction. But don't worry, don't worry. We'll assume someone will come along to deconstruct that shortly. And that they won't be horrible at construction. Or have a one. A one. Yeah, that's... It's fine. It's fine. Yep, we're just getting heat damage. There we go. There we go. Now it should be flowing just... Okay, almost flowing just grand. Just... Jesus. Just... Alright, here it comes at 10 kilo packets. That means it shouldn't break in the pipes anymore. Dear Lord. That was inconvenient. You'll notice here these pipes, they've been chilled already. They're down to minus 43. That's because that's igneous rock and it's not very good at, you know, resisting the liquids passing through it. This stuff will cool as well, but not nearly as quickly. It's much more resistant. It's got a thermal conductivity of 0.019. Igneous rock is only at 0.63. Yeah. Oh well. It happens. Oh, yeah, we should probably hook up those tanks. This here is configured as a scout rocket, so I'm not going to actually be using that. I've been checking all the achievements, and none of them require us to do any more scouting. The reason being, there's only four planets we have yet left to explore. In fact, two of them we're going to be hitting up in a minute, and oh my god, stop. What are you doing? No, we want you to... Stay right there. Don't move. How many tiles you got left? 11. Damn it, did we mess that up? I think we messed that up. You have 11 as well. No. No, you're fine. We'll land you and get you back out of there. All right. But as I was saying, to hook these up, we'll just run a quick spur out of there and a quick spur out of there with ceramic. And that will slowly fill those two tanks up with 1,800 kilos of hydrogen. In fact, yeah, there's more than enough hydrogen in there to fill all the tanks. So... Let's start filling the lot, shall we? That was not ceramic, was it? We're going to use only ceramic out here, just because, you know, what with there being rockets and stuff all over the place. Okay. You know what? I think I might leave it a minute before I land on this one. We need to be able to land here and quickly... Wow. That place is a mess. That place looks like somewhere we might want to land. If we can land our rocket there... We can probably get entombed in Regolith really, really quickly and efficiently. This is the problem. Nope. Not going to worry about that one. That planet can wait a minute. We're going to land on this one. This one should be an awful lot easier. It's a... Oh, wow, this one's tiny. Well, I think I made a bit of a mistake. We'll cover that in a minute. We might be able to rectify this. I'm not making any promises. Which record were we dealing with here? Okay, Brendan. Yep, Brendan has now left as well. Yeah, I forgot to put in the Atmosuit dock exit. Yep, I was an idiot. So we're going to need to be really, really, really quick here. Wait. Millington, how do you have a suit? They must have actually put it on even though there wasn't an Atmosuit dock. I tried to drop a suit off the rack and they just sort of insta-teleported into it, maybe. I really thought we were doomed there. Well, you know what? Just in case that's some sort of graphical glitch, we are not messing about. We are immediately going to put together the rocket. No ifs, ands, or buts. We're not even going to try and make this pleasant or nice. Come on, hurry up. Oh, we're also going to need some sort of ladder material. Yeah, we can do that in a second. There we go. They'll be done in no time at all. Guys, come on. you let me down here. Now, the reason we came down this side was, well, germs. If you check over... Oh, damn it. Well, from what we could see at the start, there was germs over here, loads of germs over here and here, and over here there wasn't any germs, which means we could dig in. But of course, just the layer below it, which we couldn't see, is full of germs. Ooh, there's a friend. Go down and... No, we're not defrosting a friend while we're here. We're just here to grab as many artifacts as we can and get out. If this planet actually has artifacts, which it may not. You never know. While we're here, we might grab a little bit of gold. Why not? Ooh, and some of those buddy bud plants. They always come in handy. Yep, not that I can stand under a rocket exhaust. Oh, no, that's right. Stand directly beneath it, just at the right time. Ah, every time. Now, we'll just build a ladder up there so that we can get the rest of our duplicates out. In fact, we should probably put on an atmosuit checkpoint. Might have been a smart plan to do that already. We have had to cancel their nap time for a little bit. Turns out I brought them down just a little early in their schedule, but it's fine. We'll have them in bed in no time. Alright, they're all gone to bed. Well, except for Millington, they're scratching themselves like an absolute addict. That's our normal setup done. They can stay here, sort this place out. They're going to dig all the way through to this section and grab us whatever that is? It looks... What kind... A useless machine. Okay, it's a box with a switch on it. Got it. I'm sure there's some... that's a reference to something. I just don't get it. Buddy, we're also going to grab some buddy bud while we're here. And I don't think there's anything else we want from this planet. It doesn't have any biomes we haven't seen before. And barring some gold amalgam, we can bring some of that back. I think that's all we need from here. So that brings us back to... Filfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfilfil and I better make sure that I build the atmosuit docks before we jump. After a good night's sleep, everyone is ready to go first thing in the morning, and I'm thinking, well, the door's there, so I kind of want to go there. But we're going to need to dig up here and grab our hands on that Mafic Rop and stuff. We're going to need some resources. Nope, not abandoned ship. View interior. That abandoned ship feels bizarrely way too close to the view interior button. I'll go grab a suit. Perfect. Then we will deploy our next duplicate. That's going to be actually Hubert. Can you build? Bizarrely enough, our rancher actually has better construction. I suppose Leonard's been around longer. Well, Leonard, looks like you're going down too. We brought Leonard along to tame ourselves a shovel. And let's view the interior as well and make sure you don't do anything silly. Come on, go grab a suit. Perfection. Now we're probably going to build a rocket right above your heads. And, ooh, there's a shovel. Why can we see that shovel? And that one. I think it glitched out because it just revealed a massive amount of... Yeah, it only glitched out for a split second. I should have left that up. All right. You, deconstruct that. You, deconstruct that. And then... Ooh. I think we'll sort of build ourselves the stairs up here to grab all this raw material. We're probably going to want to build ladders and walls and all sorts of things to protect our rocket once it's down. The hard part here is going to be digging out through all this regolith. Dear Lord. Yeah, and then we can dig right in here and grab ourselves some of that Mafic rock. Of course, all of that regolith is going to try and fall on top of us. We should have brought better diggers. It's fine. It's fine. We got this. We got this. Notice we still have no option to build yet because we haven't actually dug into anything. It isn't regolith. What's the temperature of all that regolith? That's super cold regolith. We could bring that home as filtration medium. No, no. We will worry about that later. Oh my god, just give us some regolith, or not regolith, some Mafic rock, something, anything so we can start building. Oh yes, at last. Okay, so you, right over there guys, you got this. Oh, they've got sunstroke. Yeah, turns out it's really bright out here. What's the rads like? It's only 244, they've had worse. And then we just gotta build that up like that. No problems, you guys got this. Okay, for once, the rocket's gonna land here and not scald everyone. They can't actually even step beneath it, so we should be fine. And you guys can dig down there. I'm guessing there's... Yep, I can see what's probably an artifact down there. All right, let's let them get on with it. And soon we'll have a couple of bunker doors up here. Then all we needed to do is wait for a meteor shower to hit, which I presume will happen at some point. Then we need to go grab ourselves some shovels. I'm not sure how we're going to tame one. Or even catch one. I didn't bring any plastic, did I? I'm an idiot. So how do we capture... Actually, no. We find their eggs. If we can find some eggs, that will sort us. assuming they've laid some eggs. That could be an egg. That actually is not moving. Let's go down and see what that is, shall we? Well, all right, once we've got the bunker doors finished. Oh, look at them eating in unison. They've had such a productive day, and they're covered in radioactive lesions. So proud of them. How's this crowd doing? This crowd has done... Hey, there's the tree! That's what was in here. I thought this was just going to be another one of those... what do you call it? One of those ones with the slicksters inside. Not the slicksters, the morbs. That's it. I was thinking there was going to be morbs in there. We're going to grab you, and we're also going to grab you. I think that's all we need from here. We'll be back for the tree once we've finished all the achievements, but... Oh, and we can't inspect that item. Perfect. Anything else left? No, I think we're good. Oh, and there's magma on this planet. Well, who cares? Let's just get what we came for and get out, I suppose. This time around, I was safe. I didn't dig up any of the slime. Well, we did dig up some slime, but we made sure it fell directly into water. No germs anywhere. So we can come back to here without having to worry about getting ultra-contaminated. And, oh, second desk. Inspect. Perfect. We've got everything, I think, from this planet? Yeah, we'll load the gold up into this. We'll load up the... we'll get the two items close by. Then we'll move them all into the ship. But in the meantime, how are we doing over here on Filfatatel? We got a neural vacillator. You know what? We'll dig it out. Why not? And we also got two artifacts. Perfect. And then we need to dig out over here. Yeah, that's going to be a bit of digging. Oh, and we might as well get our hands on a little bit more mafic rock while we're at it. We're going to need it. Then we can dig a ladder down right there. And hopefully that's an egg. I'm really hopeful. Actually, no. Let's make sure. Let's open it together. Make sure it's right. Otherwise, I'm going to be very annoyed. That's going to require us to get an awful lot of regolith, but that is also good. Yeah, I'm liking how these two missions are turning out. I thought these were going to be much harder. If that's an egg, this was super simple. If it's not, we may have a bit of a problem. Uh-oh. I just heard something. Yeah, that's meteor shower. I'm not sure if I should bring everyone back inside the rocket while this happens, or just leave them outside. You know what? Let's crew up, people. Get back inside. At least there you're a little bit safer. I was completely going to bug our solar panels, but you know what? Who cares? Yeah, let's stay inside, shall we? I don't want to be out there in this weather. It seems a little... rough. This is taking too long. I'm going to let them back to work. Oh, actually, that's right. I got to go back to Postilino here. The crew inside should be dismantling their beds so that we can load up the resources. Why did I dismantle all their beds? That was kind of pointless. Two of those should be fine. One of the furniture ones for, yeah, loading up the statues. And then we can get everyone out of here. There we go. Everyone on board, gold stowed away, atmosuits, cobalt, steel, everything sorted. Time to go home. You got everything you needed off this. All we needed was those two artifacts, realistically. And we'll be back for that friend. Probably. I mean, come on, they've been there for probably thousands of years. What's another few cycles? And yet we definitely still have enough range to come home. Perfect. Well, that's done. What warnings are we looking for? Just go already. Done. Now, back on Filfatatel. Everyone should be napping? Sleeping? Yeah. Wow, you guys are really badly sunburned. I've made a few changes out here. I've walled in across the top here to stop them getting so sunburned when they're out there. And I've still extracted a few more resources. And we still haven't seen if that's an egg there. But we will in a minute. Red alert. Red alert. We've got a shovel. Please tell me they're not too old. 15 years of age? Yes. Okay. Now, right. We need some way of actually enclosing them in something. No problems. No problems at all. We can build steel tiles. We have metal. We can make steel tiles here. Ooh. Damn it. Let me think for one moment. So, yeah. This is going to be simple. We'll make this a priority 7. And you know what? We will get rid of that and we'll make that a door as well, just so that we can go in at that side. We're going to try and drill down here, build that tile underneath it diagonally so we don't have to worry about that thing escaping anytime soon. Guys, do you want to build this? And we're even managing to use this steel bunker tile, which is lying around. And this whole thing is nicely shielded as well. Then all we have to do is stick in a station in there to go with it. And we've got scaldings that can only mean one thing. Someone has come home. Where are you? Yeah, Zap is back. That means they have brought, well, let's see, 9 tons of water and 3.6 tons of hydrogen. Right. Now, I don't really have room for the hydrogen at the moment. We've actually filled up our rockets faster than I was anticipating. But that is okay. That will be fine. And guys, why is that one not filling? What's going on? Oh. Damn it. Yeah. Filled it from... How I am filling these is I'm getting the dragging from here to here. Instead, I dragged from the backup. So, no, that's not good. We don't want to go from the overflow. We want to go from the primary. We'll delete that and start from scratch. But we should be able to fill both these rockets and then probably a third one after that. But that can all wait. I want to finish here. Make sure this gets done before we do something stupid. So let's finish this off one thing at a time. It's all my brain can handle. Judging by that noise, it's raining again. Would you guys try not to get yourselves entombed? That would be really useful. Ooh. Come on. Come on. Okay, we're also going to dig that section out there. Perfect. You guys are almost got it sealed. Just please get it sealed before that shovel decides to start moving again. You just got the door to do. Come on. There we go. Perfect. That means we are now safe. So, station-wise, we'll just stick down one of these grooming stations. It doesn't even matter what it's made out of. We'll make it out of steel. Oh. Then, at the same time, we can do a critter drop-off as well. That way we can drop off the vault. And in the next... After that, we should be able to knock out an achievement. In fact, that will be our second achievement of the day. Oh, and this is one of the reasons I put those bunker doors up there. It helps shield this the bottom of the silo. I don't want any of that entombing the bottom of our rocket. It could cause us a whole bunch of problems. But we're still going to have to dig off the top. And hey, someone want to actually build the automation wire? That would be really nice, guys. And then here we are just about finished. Why is that outside of a stable? Oh my god, I made it too small. I am an idiot. Fine, I'll enhance it. Ooh, the shovel just decided that it was no longer trussed up. Well, that's nice. At the same time, I really am curious to see what's in here. Oh, let's make that a level 9 and get someone down here to have a quick dig. Is that an egg or what is it? And how did I accidentally dig over there? You know what? Do not care. God damn it. God freaking damn it. The shovel puked out a bunch of regolith and then used that to somehow diagonally get down here. I don't know how it did. It magicked its way out of the box. What the... Oh, you... It was going so well. It was going so well. Everything was perfect. Why'd you have to go and mess... Oh, Leonard's up. Leonard. Emergency. Emergency. Quickly, 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 quickly. God damn. Duh. Oh, I am really glad that thing is just dumb enough to keep hanging around like that. Oh. Okay. It's fine. We're not in too much trouble. Oh, yeah, the bunker door is accidentally opened. I sort of left that signal switch on. It's fine. It'll take it about half a day to close. Half a day to open and another half a day to close. Oh, what did we catch down here? We caught a mealwood seed. All that hope for a mealwood seed. Oh, well, never mind. Well, we'll get this vole in here now and we'll sort this out and also deconstruct that. And there we go. Perfect. Now, Leonard is such a good wrangler. All they have to do is try taming that once and that should be the end of that problem. And then we can just leave. We don't really need voles right now, so we'll just, I suppose, let the vole loose. And then we can get our duplicates out of here. And you know what? Leave those doors open. Why not? We're going to be one to be leaving shortly anyway. And we're done here. The shovel is at 27% wildless left. It's going to be tamed in about half a day, and we've got 0.7 of a day of grooming on it, so it'll be fine. And there's the shovel just chowing down. You know what? We're going to leave them all here doing what they're doing. We don't care. If we check inside here, we've got ourselves a whole bunch of resources. We have, where is it? Ah, the steel is back on board. 37 tons of regolith. We got those 2 trophies, and we've got our beds back in place. Schedule-wise, it should just be... Yeah, it's just coming up on lunchtime, so... I say we go home. Oh, let's make sure we've changed the crew. Yep, they're all there. All the crew on board. And let's send them back home. Perfect. 10 tiles. Done. And that's the Regolith planet dealt with. We don't need to come back here to finish off the achievements. In fact, we've already knocked out one achievement because of coming here, and that is... Where is it? Immovable object. Block a meteor from hitting your base using a bunker door. We're pretty close to finish now. We've got GMA AOK, which... Oh, that reminds me, I've... Why are you not launching? Oh, I have to acknowledge the warnings. Never mind. Yeah, I'm going to acknowledge the warnings. Begin the launch sequence, and... You going to go? Perfect. Now, back home, we had run out of chlorine, but then I was going to send someone off to the chlorine asteroid to bring back a bunch of liquid chlorine when I realized, why don't we just pump the chlorine over here? There's plenty of temperature around. And then we just sort of mop it up. I know this is the dumbest way of doing it, but we had a bunch of carbon dioxide and chlorine that fell down here. And, well, the carbon dioxide we fed to them and they destroyed it. And when after I fed them the carbon dioxide, I thought... Well, why not just feed them chlorine as well? In fact, we've got a whole canister of chlorine here when the time comes. Right now, we're just getting it from right here. So this small little gas pump is picking it up, pumping it over there and dumping it down. The chlorine gets mopped up and ends up in those little bottles. And then the bottles get manually carried over here. How many do we have to? We're still at 5 gas grass seeds. Dear Lord, what's this thing grown to at the moment? It's at 78%. Soon we'll get to harvest it again and get another chance of getting a mutated one. It's exposed to 3,000 rads. It better mutate sometime soon or I am going to absolutely lose it. Anyway, time to refuel these rockets. So before I could launch this rocket back, I had to make a few minor changes. One thing, it's carrying a whole bunch of water, which we're just going to dump on the ground. It's also carrying a whole bunch of gas. As far as I'm aware, if we just had empty storage, yeah, it comes out as a gas cargo canister. Yeah, 3.6 tons of hydrogen. Hell yeah. In fact, we're going to have that all dumped over here. We made this little gas storage thing. These canister emptiers can accept, well, just enormous amounts of resources. They'll keep dumping gas into this until infinite pressures, I believe. I don't even think there is a max limit. So we'll have all the hydrogen dumped in here. And then when we need extra hydrogen for our system, we can just add it on. Right now, though, I don't really see the point. If you look down here, this is incredible. I've looked at these before and I thought, well, back then you couldn't use the B-tinies to feed them. Back then I was like, nah, it's too much effort. But now once you've got B-tinies, you can literally automate a massive amount of hydrogen production. Hydrogen engines are really easy with this sort of thing. You don't really care. The secondary products of these things are food. They give you some plant meat, 12,000 calories, once every 30 cycles. No, we don't care about it. What's really important is the actual hydrogen. That plant meat we can... Oh, actually, I know what we can do with that plant meat. I know something that's got a wonderful appetite and doesn't care about quality. And, you know, it's all organic and it's a plant thing itself. It can be... Actually, is that carnivorous then if it's eating its own brethren? You know what? Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter in the slightest. What we will notice here, though, is if we send this out, we can send this back to this helium planet. The reason being, that planet there, turns out we were able to take most of it. We still have 22 tons left. In fact, we can't even... take back the amount it's going to give us, but we'll get another 3.6 tons of hydrogen out of this, so yes, we're going to return. The hydrogen's probably going to get a bit toastier from that, but it'll be fine. The second rocket is going over here to the swampy ore field, 74 tons of mass. I'm basically just sending out to the ones that have the most mass to make sure that we get the full amount and gives them more time to recover. I think next up we'll probably be going to the organic mass field. Well, once we drain the helium cloud, of course. Alright, then, over this section, ooh, yeah, we've managed to fuel up these rockets. In fact, you should have... Why is there no oxygen in there? Ah, yeah, I never actually connected this up, did I? Alright, let's maybe use a little bit of ceramic for this last bit. So, we'll hook you up to the overflow. Then what we'll do is we will delete the liquid bridge. Yeah, let's make that a level 9. And that will send the liquid oxygen down here and around. Well, currently it's going at 1 kilo per second, which is bad. We would prefer that it didn't do that. That 1 kilo is going to overheat in a while. Never mind, made it to the tank. Hey, guys, it's level 9. Anyone want to get on that? Come on. Done. And that's liquid oxygen sorted. All right, let's see what kind of range we've got on this already. We're up to 5 tiles. Also, these things come with a built-in artifact? thing? One second. For some reason, I thought these engines could hold an artifact in them by default. Never mind, can't find anything on that in the wiki. I don't know where I thought that. Maybe it's petroleum engines. Anyway, the range on these things is 32 tiles with these current setups, as in two full liquid tanks of hydrogen and one liquid tank of oxygen. The combination of those two gives you that range. You could add on two more liquid tanks and one more oxidizer tank to get even more range out of this. I think that'd just about fit, but you'd probably, well, you wouldn't get much else on there, to be honest. Now, while we're at it, a good printing opportunity has shown up. It's the option to print a shovel on this planet, which, yes, we'll take it. We're immediately going to wrangle you up. In fact, we're going to make that the super duperest highest priority before that thing tries to get away or do something stupid, like eat something and vomit into that hole. If that thing vomited into that hole, that would be an incredibly horrible problem. But it's fine. It will now end up getting yanked over here. And then any eggs or anything will probably dump into that thing. But we'll store them in here inside this steel cage to make sure they don't get out, because everyone knows having a shovel running around your base is just so much fun. Come on, dump them in there. Perfect. Just wanted to make sure they didn't get accidentally dropped along the way and gum up some work somewhere. Oh, and we have an achievement earned. I'm guessing it's the critter one. Critter Whisperer, tame every single critter. Finally, that shovel on the other planet is now tamed. Oh, beautiful. Now, this one, not okay, but pretty cool. Cooler building down to 6 Kelvin. We're going to do that at the end, as in what I'm going to do is crank the temperature controls on our liquid hydrogen down to absolute zero and then just freeze this whole thing solid. That should freeze the liquid pump, which should gain us that achievement. So that one we can do at the very, very end. As for the Great Escape, we still haven't found the temporal tear. That is what is killing me. And, oh, study different terrestrial artifacts. We found 10 terrestrial artifacts. That means we need four more space artifacts, and we've done that one. That one we can knock out pretty easy, actually. Temporal tear one, I'm worried about that, but that leaves reduced temperature, and we've got that totally tubular, maybe in a bit. Then we've got mining the gap, we're working on it. Cluster conquest, just we have to land on two more planets, easy peasy. And still the GMO A-OK, we're working on it. Dear Lord, how many seeds have we up to at this point? Come on, give me a look. We've got 7 seeds and not a single mutation. Not one. What the hell? No, it's fine. It's fine. We've actually got 55 kilos of chlorine. Guys, maybe mop up some more. You know what? I am going to turn that gas pump off. We don't need... We've got plenty of chlorine for now. We'll worry about the rest later. What we want to do right now is we want to get this rocket configured. This is going to be our exploration rocket for far, far, far away. So give me one moment while we make a few modifications here. Unfortunately, there's been a minor delay. The delay was caused by... Well, actually, it was caused out here. When I was zipping these spacefare modules up and down to make building easier, I accidentally made a mistake and lined up the input port here with the hydrogen line. So we may have a teeny tiny little bit of hydrogen that got into the capsule. Oops, I suppose. But that's fine. Right now we've got all of that being filtered out, and soon we'll have a vacuum capsule that we can fill. It'll be no problems at all. While we wait for all of that hydrogen to be drained out, that could take a minute or two. There's a couple of changes we need to make outside that will require a little bit of finicky stuff. Down here, we're using this radiation to power our mutated plants. Our mutated plants require radiation or they won't grow. So this one requires 250 rads. All of them require 250 rads or they won't grow because they're mutated versions. That's a problem because we have to cover in the top here. Otherwise, these solar panels are going to get toasted. Actually, now I think about that, might not be a problem. If we just disable auto repair, we should be fine. I mean, if you'll notice here, it's not actually exchanging temperature. Ooh, that's sneaky. What if we just disable auto repair on all of these? Now, okay, we'll do the sneaky bit as well, but only a little bit. What I was going to do, which was doing some research on what was the best thing to use to block rads, and it turns out it's these doors. I know that seems really dumb, but yes, it's these old school manual airlocks made of steel. So if we put that down, like, say, there, and there, and finally there. Yeah, damn it, one moment. Yeah, that looks more like it. So that should help. At the same time, we're going to want to block the rocket exhaust from cooking everything over here. So I'm afraid it's time to break out the obsidian tiles and... Oh, say, right, like, oh, wait, we'll do it up to... Actually, there is fine. Why not? We're going to have to leave ourselves a doorway in, probably. I'm thinking here. Seems like a reasonable spot to put in the doorway. Perfect. That should stop the rocket exhaust from getting over there. Or getting... Well, if we touches that door, that would be problematic for us. I put in those doors because I wanted to be able to service this place. Plus, we have a big bunch of hydrogen in there. I've turned down the cooling on this little. I had it up at 255 for a while because I thought it'd stabilize, but I had to turn this down. This has been a little bit finicky. Maybe not my best design. But hey, it's working well enough for now. And here we go. Radiation. You'll notice that... Oh, God. Okay, so there's 350... 70? Why is the rads fluctuating so heavily there? What is going on? Oh, there's gas coming out of here. And that gas is messing with everything down below. Okay, okay, fine, never mind, got it. I'll try something a little bit more stable here. 375 rads. And after it passes through the doors, we've still got 282. And by the time it gets down to the plants, they're all still golden. So this way we're able to... Well, you're not. God damn it. You're down to... 262 rads. Why are you... Okay, it's fluctuating. Probably due to the gases we're spitting out of there. That's not perfect yet. Those gases are actually bringing it down just below the required amount. That's not good. Okay, at the same time, we're going to... Yeah, we've disabled auto repair on these. We might just let these get cooked and then not worry about it. All right, but that will be for the next episode, because I am, of course, way over budget again. For the next planet, though, that is the big question. You see, the thing is, there's only two planets left. There's fire, the fire planet and the ice planet. The problem we face is, which one do we go to first? We've got to go to both, but I need to know which one's got the rift opener? What's it called? One second. The Great Escape. Open the temporal tear by activating the temporal tear opener. Now, from what I can see, unless I've missed it, it's not on any of the planets we've visited so far. Though then again, it could be over here on the leftmost corner of Heferato, because I never explored that. That's... Okay, my bad. When it comes to Ikiani, we've explored that pretty much stem to stern. There is nothing left to explore, unless it's hidden down in the magma, which I severely doubt. Contrelia is our teleporter planet. It's the one that we just teleported right to, and I don't see it there either. And we can see pretty much the entirety of that planet. The oil planet... Same again, we've explored all of that but a little bit of a corner down here, and I don't think it's that low down. Tampona, yeah, same again. Water planet, we've explored pretty much all of it, unless it's hidden in that tiny blob, which, you know, we would have seen it. Frostona, which is the one where we got our seeds from, it could be over there. So that's two potential places so far, in places we've already explored, and this one, no, this is too tiny. There's no way it could be hiding here, unless it's really low down. I consider that highly unlikely. And finally, we've got... Fifeltel or whatever it's called, and oh wow, it's actually entombed our rocket platform, so we can't even land there if we wanted to. That's fine. That is fine, but I don't think it's there either. Well, it could be over here, actually. Ooh, that might explain it. I hear that when you activate it, it causes a meteor swarm, so this might be the planet. Okay, so I suppose next planet up, I'm thinking we go to fire planet then. The fire planet should have niobium. That niobium we can use, yeah, it's got niobium down there, so we can use that to make some of the more advanced stuff. So yeah, we'll go to that planet next, and then we might want to actually build another hydrogen rocket. We've actually got the liquid to run a third one. So, and oh, we're going to have to start exploring with this one. This exploration rocket's job is going to be to go to, say, the retired excursion module, the destroyed satellite, ruined rockets. It's basically going to go around and pick up four space artifacts for us, bring them all back so that we can analyze them, and knock out one other achievement, which is, oh God, cosmic archaeology. We just need to study four more space artifacts, and we've got, well, the majority of the achievements knocked out. Anyway, before I wander any more, I hope you enjoyed, and good luck.